Over the past few years, a number of former players have committed suicide after battling depression. Afterwards, they gave their brains to science, and upon examination, they showed telltale signs of CTE. Scientists don't yet have a way of diagnosing CTE for sure besides doing an autopsy. So apart from the 50 deceased former players confirmed to have it, they can only suspect that hundreds more are living with it right now.
978432.
978.
For a while, the NFL was completely repressing research. They were telling players that concussions were a relatively safe type of injury to suffer. But with pressure mounting, the league changed course, settling a class action suit for $765 million and pouring money into CTE research. The issue hasn't gone away at all. The NFL's been trying to solve it, and it seems like they're putting genuine efforts into it, but it just might not be possible. In theory, concussed players are no longer allowed to enter games. They've moved the kickoff 5 yards down the field, so a lot more kickoffs become touchbacks, so you don't have the high-speed impacts happen when the kicking team is trying to cover the kick and tackle the player.
Deion Jones does not hit with the crown of his helmet. He hits with the side of his helmet. And plus, Cam Newton, how as I understand the rule, is not a defenseless player. He is the...